Hey guys, it's Tracy with Young Hollywood, and I am with the one and the only Chelsea Handler.
Chelsea Handler!
Chelsea Handler is here. But wait, we have to do the official intro.
So okay.
Hold on, because we're in these chairs.
Oh, right? Yeah. Right. Coach Lund. Well, mine doesn't move.
What?
All right, here, I'll just do this. Ready?
Oh, hello.
Oh, hi. Hi, how are you?
I did pretty well on that.
Yes.
Right? We are twinning, and I swear to God, I did not plan this. But I kind of did, because I know that you like banties.
Oh, thanks. Right? Yeah, I do.
Yours is a lot cooler than mine. I don't really know what this is.
Mine's a lot fuller than yours, too.
So we're here on the set of your Netflix show. And by the way, today I saw the episode 80s theme. First of all, I'm still not over the interview with Bob Saget, because I literally grew up watching
with him,
Full House.
Thinking he was your father.
Yeah.
And then finding out that he wasn't.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And he's everybody's grandfather. Nobody's like squeaky clean Danny Tanner, and then he's like sitting here talking to you about making a baby on your couch.
He is a filthy man. Bob Saget is a filthy, disgusting man. And if you see him walking towards you late at night, you should run in the other direction.
Can I tell you, one time I actually did see him at something, and I was like, Bob Saget is here, and he's not the Bob Saget that I grew up with.
Copy that.
But any other 80s, like, who did you grow up with?
I grew up, well, everything. The Cosby Show, Family Ties. Reruns of Three's Company were like my stalwart. Like, that was my favorite. Every night it would be like, come and knock on my door at 7:30. And then at 8, yeah. Like Thursday night was the lineup. So there were a lot of good things happening in the 80s. It was really good TV
time. I miss
the
80s. I mean, I was born in the 80s, but like, those were the good days, right?
Well, yeah, I mean, the 90s were more embarrassing than the 80s, definitely. Yeah.
What was an embarrassing
Like, the 90s were
thing.
Just like puberty for me. Like, I was 10 in the 80s, so it was fine, and I was like, I didn't really become a teenager or an adult until the 90s. The 90s were like an embarrassing decade. And there nothing good came out of the 90s. I mean, I'm sure anyone could argue that point, but I don't really think a lot of good things came from that decade.
But do you embarrass easily? Because I feel like, I mean, you let it all out, literally, figuratively.
I've shamed myself so many times over the years that, yes, no, I don't embarrass easily anymore. But yes, you can embarrass me. I mean,
really?
I've done most of it already, so I don't know how many. I think there's like a lid.
That's what I was gonna say. Like, is there something you haven't
there's
done?
There's a certain amount. There's like a cap about how much one can embarrass themselves.
Well, I mean, just speaking of embarrassing stories, I do have to just bring up one
of
mine, because my most embarrassing story was actually with you.
Oh, whoopsie.
But I don't know if you would remember this, but we actually met 10 years ago when you started Chelsea Lately. I was on one of the test shows as a guest panelist.
Oh, yeah? As like on the round table.
Exactly.
Okay.
But needless to say, I did not get a call back.
Oh.
And the reason was I came out there and you were talking about Kelly Clarkson and Clive Davis, and there was some feud going on between them. And I was so nervous. I was sitting there like in silence, and I'm just like,
oh, no,
I need to
sorry.
Contribute to this conversation. Like, I got to say something. And in my head, I was thinking of Clive Owen for some weird reason. So I don't know if you remember this, but I just like chimed in and I was just like, well, at least Clive is hot. I just remember the whole audience like got silent and you gave me this like horrified look, and you're
right.
Just like, oh, if that's like your thing, okay.
Yeah.
And then the weird thing is I didn't even realize who I was talking. I still thought I was like being serious. I'm like, no, like he really
sounds
is.
Like you deserved it. Right? I mean, way off topic.
No, way off topic.
Yeah, you sound like you deserve to be embarrassed at that point.
I did bring pictures just to redeem myself in front of you.
Yeah, which one is, who is who?
Who is who?
I'm like, yeah, if you're into that, you would love Sumner Redstone, for instance, if you're into that.
I would.
Yes.
But I wanted to just tell you that I'm not into 80-year-olds.
Okay.
I don't know, are you?
No, not anymore. I had a really bad run-in with one.
But another thing is that you inspired me to keep going, because I was really like wanting to crawl in the hole and die for a while.
That's the worst feeling.
It
but
is.
You know what? It's good
but
to
you
fall
But you inspired
down.
Me to keep going.
Well, I'm glad
so
I did.
So I wanted
and
to thank you
now.
In person.
Look at
yeah.
You now.
At least
Hello.
I got to.
That's different. So see, it's all good. We've all humiliated ourselves like that. Believe me, I got fired from so many jobs. I was humiliated over and over again. And then finally I was like, I'm sick of people humiliating me. I'm going to start doing it myself.
But which is exactly why I think the Netflix show Chelsea is so... It's just so refreshing. It's so like incredible to see you getting a chance to actually just be you. You don't care. You're like, this is who I am. I'm going to say what I want, do what I want.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate
and,
that.
And I mean, is there anything that's off limits really for the show, or does Netflix kind of just let you do
like ugly babies? I think it's probably not so nice to make fun of ugly babies, not on air. Obviously, I'll do it with my friends. But
didn't you talk about Asian babies once?
Asian, tiny,
there's
gentle Asians is an Instagram that you can follow. They
yes.
have cute little Asian babies. Those are cute, though. All Asian babies are cute.
They are cute.
Yeah. No, I try not to make fun of babies or anyone that's dying. That's not really funny. You know, after they're dead, like if you wait enough time, then anything's funny. But yeah, there are a couple things I won't talk about, but those things are of no interest to me, so it's not a battle anyway.
So, but like, when you talk about politics, you know, and a lot of it too is like you're actually learning, you're asking questions. But it's really interesting because even if you're watching the show, which I binge watched, of course, on Netflix, you really do learn something every single time. And it's cool because a lot of celebrities who come on, like, they're just promoting themselves or whatever, but you really get them to talk about something that's important to you.
I try. I want someone to say something interesting. I mean, doesn't everybody want something interesting to happen?
Yeah, well, exactly.
Right.
But how is it just sort of like, how do you feel like you bring that out of people so much?
I don't know. I mean, I don't think I do a good job of really anything except being myself. So I just like to have conversations with anybody. So it doesn't matter if you're a celebrity or not, I'm kind of interested.
And how do you like come up with like your concepts? Like one day you're going to Russia, another time you're having people
just
in the studio.
Just throw a bunch of stuff at a wall and see what sticks. You know, that's like, all I wanted was to have a show that didn't have a format so that one night you can turn it on and see Reese Witherspoon and Common and me and a group of people having a conversation about religion. Or you can turn it on, it can be me in Russia. Or you can turn it on and there's a bunch of studio guests. I wanted to not have a format, and I've done it, and I'm so happy that I did, because who decided about a format? Who was decided that?
Screw format.
They told me
right?
I could have a dog on my show. I was like, no, I'm going to have my dog on my show. This is no
cutest
format.
Cutest dog ever, by the way.
Well, he's pretty cute, but I got another one up my sleeve, and her name is Tammy, and she's got a pass.
Does Tammy, like, make it into the studio, or
sometimes,
is it mostly
if
Chunky?
She sneaks in, she does.
How did you choose, like, one or the other? You're like, Chunky's going to be the star.
Chunk is my man. Oh. He's, like, my firstborn, so I'm more loyal to... I mean, I choose Chunk over Tammy. Oh, shit, I hope he didn't hear me.
And then Stranger Things, you said you binge-watched, which, by the way, it's funny, we had the cast actually at our studio.
Guys, if it's something disgusting, I'm genuinely going to freak.
Oh my god! Dang it!
Okay. Oh my god, no.
Oh! I have to watch the show. I heard it's incredible.
You have to, yeah, I mean, it's just so it's just like a total blast from the past because it reminds you of all the stuff of the 80s. And even if you're too young to remember the 80s, it's cool. Just all these kids on their bikes, and it's scary, but it's not scary because it's sci-fi, so it's like over the top scary. So you can watch it alone. I just like binge watching anything. So anytime there's an original series on Netflix, I watch it. I'm not biased, I don't think. I think everybody in the world does.
I mean, I feel like, don't you feel like you've made it in life? Like now you have your own show on Netflix and you have a show that like has never been done before on like,
I don't ever feel like I've made it in life. Not really.
You already made it in life a long time ago.
A little bit. Sometimes I'm like, oh, this is nice. Who cleaned my shower? But other than that, I don't ever be like, yep, nailed it. I'm going to go to bed tonight. I'm always like, how am I going to go to bed tonight? Is it going to be chocolate pot? Anyway.
Pie,
what kind of audience
vodka,
are we talking to?
Whatever you need.
Yeah, vodka.
So is there anything that's like been challenging or surprising to you? Kind of.
Yeah,
in the process?
Everything's challenging. Everything's, you know, time management is challenging when you're doing a show like this. You work like, you know, a lot and a million things are coming at you, but it's the good kind of challenging. It's not anything I would ever be like, why am I doing this? I don't really like to complain. I mean, I like to complain about my body image or my weight. But those are really the only things I ever complain about. And I try to keep that to a dull roar also.
Right.
It's not really that interesting, people talking about their bodies, you know?
Well, and you're fine showing your body, which is empowering though, and empowers women to like, be comfortable with who
they are. Gotta get those boobies out. Gotta show them who's boss.
Do you have any guests that you haven't had yet that you really want to have in the studio? Or do anything crazy with?
I'd like Clive Owen. He's hot.
Oh, yeah.
I'm into him big time.
You're gonna have to get them together, and then I'll have to come in.
Clive
and be
Owen.
An audience.
It was clock is ticking on that. I think.
I mean, it's like... Clive. Oh, you just got it confused.
Oh, Clive. Yeah, Clive Davis. I meant.
See, it's.
Sorry.
I'm not the only
to
one.
To both of you.
Lastly, though, you also talk about marriage. So marriage and kids are just not your thing.
No.
Kids are just not happening.
Not
for
happening
you.
For me. I'm an independent woman. Hear me roar.
We hear you. We hear you loud and clear on a lot of the PSAs. You do. Well, you just are hilarious. You're amazing.
Thank you.
I'm
glad you got your act together and that you're able to decipher the difference between the two of them.
But I still stand by my statement that Clive Owen is hot, right?
All right. Yeah. Victory.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye.
Nice to meet you.